The .htaccess file, where ht stands for hypertext, is a configuration file used on Apache web servers. It allows you to create a simple 301 redirect, redirect to URLs with trailing slash, which are URLs with a forward slash at the back. It is a good SEO practice. You can redirect non-www version of a domain to a www version or vice versa. Do a site-wide redirect from an old domain to a new domain. Leverage browser caching and many other functions. And in this video, let me share with you how to edit the .htaccess file to perform the functions I've mentioned using RankMath. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one tool that provides easy-to-use SEO and AI tools, and this channel provides you with tips, tricks, and tutorials to grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, consider subscribing. Now, if you are totally new to building websites, this might be a little technical, but I would try my best to make it as simple and easy for you. If you are on WordPress, you can simply access and edit your .htaccess file when you hover over RankMath SEO and visit its general settings. And right here, you will see the option to edit your .htaccess file. If you don't see this option, then you want to visit RankMath's dashboard and toggle the advanced mode. Once you have done that, on your general settings, you will be able to see this option. Now, there may be instances where you will see that RankMath couldn't find the file, and that's because the file is not found on your server. The files and folders on your server work very similarly to the files and folders on your computer, and you can access them either through FTP, or in my case, I'm accessing them through the cPanel's file manager, which is provided by your web server. And when you visit your site's folder, which is what we call the root folder of your site, you will see the .htaccess file here. This is the backup file automatically created by RankMath. So if you have made mistakes to the original file, you can restore it. I will show you how in a while. Now, if RankMath couldn't find this file here, you will see the error. Let's try this. Let me remove these files. Head back to your site and refresh it. Now you will see the error. And if you are seeing this error, all you need to do is in your root folder, you want to click on add file and you want to name it .htaccess and create the file. Now, if you are not able to create a file, then you may want to contact your web host to have them add it for you. Anyway, back to the site, refresh it, and now you will see that the file is blank. So what you want to do next is to visit this page. This is the URL. We have left a link in the description. You want to scroll down to 4.2. And right here, this set of code is standard for all basic WordPress sites, as it allows WordPress to manage your permalinks. For multi-sites, you want to check out this link. So over here, you want to select everything and copy the code. Back to your .htaccess file, you want to check this and paste the code here, and then save changes. And thereafter, if you need to make amendments or add functionalities to this file, you don't need to visit the file on your server. You can access it directly from RankMath. Now, in case you see a message like this where it says .htaccess file is not writable, you will want to add this filter to your site. And if you need a guide on how to add the filter, you want to check out this page. It will walk you through step by step on how to do it. We have left a link to this page in the description. So that's how you can create, access, and edit your .htaccess file. So now let's talk about some use cases. Using the .htaccess file, you can easily create a simple 301 redirect. So let's say for some reason I wish to redirect this page, the top BBQ grill safety practices, to the 5 best gas grills. To do that, we can leverage on the .htaccess file. Now, as we said earlier, if you want to make amendments to this file, you have to check this box. Otherwise, you will not be able to make any amendments to this file. So let's check this, and now we can write the rule. To do a simple 301 redirect, you want to write a rule like this, where it says redirect 301, which is a permanent redirect. And then you want to replace this previous URL with the page URL you wish to redirect. So let's open up this link, and this is the URL we wish to redirect. Let's copy it and paste it here. You can leave it like this, or you can remove the domain, but you gotta start with the forward slash, and following that, the URL slug. Next, since we want to redirect from this page to this, this will be the destination URL, and we gotta replace this with the destination URL. Now, before I hit save changes, check this out. This is the URL we wish to redirect. As I save changes, the rule is now saved. Now, as I hit refresh, it will be redirected to the destination URL. It is as simple as that. Now, of course, if you are not a technical person, you will try not to use the .htaccess file as much as possible. And we have a redirections body where you can perform the same task. So if you want to learn more about that, you can check out this video right here. The link is in the description. Next, let's check out how you can do a redirect from all URLs of your old domain to a new domain using the .htaccess file. Now, this is a very common issue. At times you have bought a domain name, but over time you don't really like it anymore, or you wish to rebrand your website with a new domain name, but you do not want to lose any of the link juice or SEO benefits accumulated by the old domain name. This is what you need to do. You have to write a rule like this on the htaccess file of your old domain and replace these with the old domain and this with the new domain. So these set of characters are basically regex characters, which is a short form for regular expressions. If you want to understand more about regular expressions and how they work, you can check out this video right here. The link is in the description. Anyway, let's copy this rule, head back to our .htaccess file, check this. We recommend to paste the codes right at the top of the file, as it didn't work for us at the bottom. And then you want to replace this with your current domain, which is the domain you want to redirect. Let's highlight this and copy it. And now over here, we want to paste this. And then in case your domain comes with the www. Right in front of it, all the URLs with the World Wide Web will be redirected as well. Now, as for the new domain, which is this, as you can see, this is mypluginstore.com, while the old domain is mypluginstore. That's the main difference. So we want to copy the new domain and replace it here, right before the $1, and make sure that there is only one slash here. And you're basically done. As we save changes, check this out. This is a URL from the old domain. As I click refresh, now you will see that the old URL has been redirected to the new URL. But of course, both the old domain and the new domain needs to have the same URL structure type. So normally when you want to migrate your site, you need to go to your old domain, download all the assets like the CSS, JavaScript, database, or whatever, and then go to the backend of the new URL and upload the files there, so that the old website and the new website will be exactly the same. And check this out as well. If I go to the old domain and hit enter, it will redirect to the new domain. And that's how you do a domain redirection without losing any SEO advantages. Now that's how you do domain redirects. And in case you are not confident if the htaccess rule will work, we recommend that you test it with this tool. This is the .htaccess tester tool, and this is the link. We have left the same link in the description. So for example, you want to test if the rule is working, all you need to do is to add a URL example of the source URL and hit test. And right below, if there are any errors, they will be flagged. So for example, if I made a mistake here, it will tell me something is wrong. As I've said earlier, having trailing slash for all your URLs is a good SEO practice because of consistency, and it is easier for search engines to crawl your URLs and avoid duplicate content issues. So if you notice some of your URLs do not have a trailing slash, and you want to use the .htaccess file to redirect them to the same URL with the trailing slash, then you'll want to visit this page. This is the URL, the link is in the description. You want to scroll down to point 2, and right here is the command to copy. No special adjustments needed, just paste this in your .htaccess file and it will work. And take note that this method will only work for sites hosted on an Apache server. Now, in case you have a domain with www. And you wish to redirect your URLs to the version without, or vice versa, here's the rule you need to add to your .htaccess file. For redirecting from a domain with www. To a domain without, you want to visit this link. Scroll down and you will see two sets of rules. I recommend using the second set because of this additional NC flag, as it includes case-sensitive characters in your domain. For example, if your domain looks like this or this, they will be included in the redirects. So just copy this code and paste it in your .htaccess file. Assuming currently this domain comes with a www. We want to copy this, replace the placeholder with your domain, and you want to copy just your domain and replace it here. Simple as that. And for the other way around, you want to visit this link. This is for the redirection of non-www version to the one with it. Scroll down and you will see this code. It is rather similar, as it is just the other way around. Now, whether you are redirecting from your domain to a subdirectory because your business is expanding worldwide, or if you have hosted your other business functions on a subdomain and now you want them to be redirected back to the main domain with the subdirectory, this is the htaccess rule you need to apply. On this page, visit point 5.5. This is the set of code you need. Let's copy it and paste it into your .htaccess file. This is where you will add the domain you would like to redirect. Let's say that this is the subdomain that hosted your courses. And then let's say that you wish to redirect all URLs in your courses subdomain to a directory like this. You will replace this with the name of your subdirectory. You will do the same here as well. And as always, if you are not confident that this will work, test it. Copy this code and paste it to the tool. Add an example source URL and test it. And here you go. Now you know the code will work. When we talk about speeding up your website, caching is always a key strategy as it can reduce your page load times and improve overall site performance significantly. In layman's terms, your website is like asking the browsers such as Google Chrome, Firefox, or whatever to keep a copy of your site's assets such as images, CSS, JavaScript, etc. For beginners, we recommend using a caching plugin like WP Rocket, but if you don't wish to use plugins at all, you can add a code like this. This will tell your site visitor's browser to store your images like JPEG, GIF, or PNG files for 1 year, since most still images are not changed frequently. If you constantly change images on your site, then you will want to reduce the caching period, such as excess 1 month. So this entire set of rules is according to the best practices, but feel free to change the caching period according to your needs. So let me share with you how to restore the backup of your htaccess file in case you mess something up, and allow me to crash the site for you. Let's say that I do this and I save changes, and let's check out my site now. Oh no, it is not working. Let me refresh again. Nothing is working. My God. So what you want to do now is to go to your cPanel or FTP, and in your root folder, as you can see, every time you have made changes to your .htaccess file, RankMath will create a backup for you. And as you can see, I've made many changes today, and since there is a time lock, I know that this is the latest file before I made the silly mistake. So what you want to do is to remove this .htaccess file, because this is the one that is causing the issue that has made your site crashed. So I will select this and I will delete the file. And then to use this htaccess backup, we want to rename it and remove any letters, leaving just the .htaccess. And as you rename the file, let's try this again. Let me refresh the page and we are back to normal. Simple and easy.
Just as you back up your website and important data, it is crucial to back up your redirects as well. Losing them can be a nightmare.
So what you want to do is to visit the RankMath's Redirections module, and right at the top, there is this import and export option. You want to select the export. And depending if your site is hosted on an Apache server or an Nginx server, you want to select the appropriate option. This is if your site is hosted on an Apache server. So I'll click on this, and the file will be downloaded to your computer. And since this is timestamped on the file name, you can easily reference it. Now, this file will contain whatever redirects that are active on your site. So if I open up this file on a text editor, you will see the active redirect. And this can be copied to your .htaccess file. Now, for RankMath Pro users, you can sync your redirects directly to the .htaccess file by clicking on this. And if you visit your cPanel file manager, open up the file, and you will see your active redirect here. So backing up your redirects with RankMath is a seamless process.
All right, these are the most common functions for the .htaccess file. And if you have any further questions, feel free to leave them in the comments down below. And don't forget to smash that thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to us, do so, because we are all about helping you grow your search traffic. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.